Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. If you're new here, my name's Riley. Thanks for being here. So as you may have seen by the title of this video, I'm gonna be doing like a general high school advice video. This video is probably gonna be most helpful to incoming freshmen and sophomores, I guess too. So if you're a junior or senior, you probably already know these tips. But without further ado, let's get on into the video. Okay, so I have a couple things written down. I'm just gonna go down the list in order that I kind of think is more important, I guess. Tip number one. You don't need a boyfriend. I know it sounds weird coming from me because I met my high school sweetheart in freshman year, but the fact in our relationship was that we both were not looking for a relationship. We both just kind of met, started talking, and I actually started to like him, and he started to like me too. And he was like, I really just don't want a girlfriend, but this girl. And I'm very happy in my relationship. You just don't need a boyfriend to be happy, and I can't stress that enough. High school boys just add a whole nother level of stress, and on top of all the stress you're gonna be having from your classes and high school in general, you just don't need that added stress, you know? Plus, high school boys are just... they're just not cute, not mature. Girls mature way faster than boys do. From my experience, all the guys in my grade were really immature. I liked Robert because he was different from everyone else. He was also 2 years older than me. And let's be honest, you're most likely not going to find the person you're going to marry in high school. For me, it may be different. I have found my one. Yeah. For some people, you may find your high school sweetheart end up getting married, but in most cases, it just doesn't happen. So don't worry about getting your heart broken and all the extra stress that you don't need. Just forget the boys, okay? Just hang with your girlfriends, make it a fun 4 years. The next topic that I'm going to be talking about is drama. It's not worth it. You can't please everyone. And I learned this in high school. I'm a people pleaser. I love to make people laugh. But the reality of that is you're not going to please everyone. There's always going to be that one person, someone, or some people that just don't like you. For example, my boyfriend Robert was in high school and he had this person that literally said, "I don't like you because you're so nice." Like, that's a thing. That actually happened. Someone actually said that. So that is a good example that people are just not gonna like you and it's okay. And then there's crap talk behind the back. No one likes to be talked about behind the back. If you catch yourself talking about someone behind their back, just stop. Don't do it. So the person that you're talking to about someone else will most likely go and tell someone, and then somehow it will get back to the person that you were crap talking. So just don't do it. Ouch, like people are talking about me like that? And why? Like, what's the point? If you ever need to like spill the beans, spill some tea, spill it with your mom, because your mom's not gonna go tell anyone. And here's a thing about friend groups. The friends you make in high school will most likely not be your friend that you bring with to college. Like, if you're going off to college, you're most likely going to make new friends. My parents always told me that you'll probably leave high school with like one or two close friends, which is so true. I literally have two friends, but that's okay. I am a completely different person that I was in freshman year than I am now. And change is great, change is okay. It's okay to not be friends with someone anymore, but it's not okay to make petty drama out of it. You don't have to be friends with someone, but don't be mean to them. Huh? What? Huh? One last thing that's kind of in that category would be nice to your teachers. Teachers get so much disrespect in this school like curriculum, but students and other teachers need to understand that they're human too. You never know what they're going through, just like anyone else. Just always be nice. Ask them how their day is going, how they're doing. If you think they're a great teacher, you like the way they teach, tell them that. Say, "I think you're a great teacher." Any kind of compliment makes someone's day. And I swear, if you tell a teacher that they're a great teacher, I just feel like it like lights up their face and it makes them happy. So yeah, be nice to your teachers. Now I'm gonna kind of get on into the academic side of high school. The next thing that I wanted to talk about is taking freshman year and sophomore year very seriously. I feel like colleges take a look mostly at freshman year and sophomore year, most likely because you're transitioning into high school and your classes are getting a little bit harder. So really pay attention to those grades those 2 years. I think the first 2 years of high school you probably learn the most, but definitely take advantage of AP and honors classes. I would suggest taking at least one or two in your high school career because most colleges love to see AP classes. If you have honors classes available to you, I definitely suggest trying those, or like IB courses, whatever your school offers that are kind of like higher level academic, because it'll show colleges that you're ready for a challenge and you're gonna do well in those classes. Junior year was probably the hardest for me because I was taking one AP class and all honors classes, and then on top of that, I was taking college classes. So I would say that was probably my hardest year. I did finish with pretty good grades. I think I got like all A's and a B and a C in a college class, but we're not gonna talk about that. The next thing that kind of goes along with that is dual enrollment classes. If your school allows it or offers it, take advantage. I cannot stress that enough. I'm pretty sure my school let us start taking the dual enrollment college classes sophomore year, and I did those classes from sophomore year to end of senior year. For me, the classes were really easy. It's just such an easy way to get college credit. From me taking these classes from sophomore year to senior year, I'm going into my freshman year in college with college credits already. I almost have a full year done of college credit. Like, why not? You're saving your parents money, you're getting a head start, you're getting like a sneak peek of what college classes might be like for you, and you're knocking out college credits. The next thing that I'm going to talk about is SAT / ACT prep classes. Ugh, no one likes the SAT or the ACT. If you like it, you're a nerd. Just kidding. No, but I hated taking these tests because these tests determine how ready you are for college. And colleges love to see good test scores on these stupid tests. Nowadays, this test honestly determines whether you get into your dream college or not. So with that being said, I would really suggest getting a SAT or ACT tutor starting sophomore year. You can start taking these tests in junior year, I think, and then it ends senior year. These tests will determine if you get scholarships or not. So here, the Florida Bright Futures, I could get money if I get a high enough score on the ACT, and that money will like pay for college, pay for books, pay for an apartment. Just scholarships are good. So really try hard in high school to earn these kind of scholarships. The last thing that I want to talk about is take advantage of Help Class. I know it's like some weird thing that someone started where if you go to Help Class, you're just dumb and you don't understand and it's so stupid and it's wasting your time. Like, no, forget that. Don't listen to whoever started that. If your teacher is offering Help Class, you better take advantage of it. Yes, it's after school, it's time where you could be doing other things, but this will help your grades for sure. At my school even, some teachers would offer extra credit help if you went to Help Class. My junior year math class, if I didn't go to Help Class before a quiz or test, I would not do good on the test or quiz. Hey, if that's what you need, that's what you need. And if your school offers it, that's awesome. Take advantage of it. So I wanted to also include like something that really changed my high school experience. And they're just like two necessities that you need in high school. So the first one is an agenda. Definitely get an agenda or planner, whatever you want to call it. If your school even offers you one, use it. So this is what I did that really helped me stay organized and turn in everything on time. I would write down my classes, and then each day in that class, I would go to that class category and write down any homework that I had. Once I completed the homework, I would cross it out. That way I knew that it was done and I could turn it in. This will help you stay organized and know your due dates. I even color-coded mine to having my quizzes, tests, and days I need to study all color-coded in my agenda. You don't have to do that, but that just helps me. And it looks aesthetically pleasing, so. The next thing that I would suggest getting for your locker would be like an emergency kit. My face gets really oily throughout the day, so I would have a little makeup thing that I could blot my oil away with. I'd have some Advil because you never know if you have a headache in school or like period cramps or something. I also kept a couple dollars in there just in case I got hungry, didn't bring a snack from home. I could use the vending machine. I kept a little thing of lotion in there because my hands always got super dry. I kept perfume, extra pencil lead, and a flosser. You never know, man. So yeah, I hope these tips and like advice, little thing, snippets, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. I hope they're helpful to you. Definitely put these into use in high school if you're coming in as a freshman. Good luck in high school. Just stay away from the drama, stay away from boys, just have a good time with your friends. High school was a memorable 4 years of my life, and I'm very excited for the next chapter. But thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, make sure to give me a thumbs up, and after you do that, I will see you in my next video.
Peace.